We welcome the next speaker for today, Maida Sarabaitia from the Helmholtz Institute Ulm, former colleague of mine, and also at Karlsruhe Institute of Technology. The topic of her presentation today is sustainable and cost-efficient, effective synthetic route of bio-waste-derived hard carbon anode materials for sodium-ion batteries.
Okay, so as it was mentioned, my name is Maida Sarabaitia, and I'm coming from Helmholtz Institute Ulm. So my topic is about the alternative and more sustainable and cost-effective synthetic route to develop a bio-waste-derived hard carbon anode material for sodium-ion batteries. So the reason maybe why we are working in sodium ion technology, maybe now is more clear due to the previous speaker, but in general, everyone knows that lithium ion batteries mainly depends on critical raw materials. For example, in this image, you can see that the several material that the European Union published as critical that are highlighted in red. So as you can see, the graphite, silicon, or even cobalt and lithium are critical raw materials by European Union. So we need to develop alternative and more sustainable or environmentally friendly energy storage devices. So in this context, the sodium ion batteries could be a good alternative. Indeed, they do not depend on critical material because as anode material, hard carbon is used instead of graphite. And for the cathode, for example, the sodium ion technology is not based on cobalt-based material rather than on manganese or iron. Also, the properties between lithium and sodium was quite similar, and as it was also explained before, although the energy density is lower for sodium ion batteries, depending on the application, is enough and can be a complement to lithium ion technology. Indeed, the main application right now that are considered for sodium ion batteries are light electromobility and for large scale applications. This is a summary, a very short summary. These are some of the companies that also was mentioned before. So we, depending on the company, what they are modifying or changing is the cathode material. There are some companies that works with lithium oxide due to the high energy density, although the cycling stability should be improved a bit more. Also, there are other companies working in this vanadium fluorophosphate due to the high power and high average voltage of the sodium ion batteries. Or there is other companies like Aldridge, Norbot, and also CLTL working in Prussian white due to the low-cost synthesis process of this cathode material. However, if you focus in all the cases, the anode of choice is hard carbon. So what is hard carbon? So hard carbon is not graphitized carbon that is composed with these pseudo-graphitic domains, but also it contains a lot of defect with some, for example, terminal surface groups, some defect in this graphitic network, and also is composed with open and closed porous structures. So the advantages of this hard carbon is the low potential insertion of the sodium due to this not a crystalline structure, no significant structural changes over the cycles happens. It delivers a high reversible capacity. Depending on the hard carbon, the capacity can go from 200 until 400 mAh per gram. And one of the advantages in order to support the recyclability is the use of bio-waste precursors to develop to manufacture this hard carbon. However, also the hard carbon has some disadvantages, and among them could be the high reversibility due to this open or more open porosity can show high or low initial coulombic efficiency, and also the density of this material is quite low compared to the graphite. So the use of bio-waste is one of the main advantages of the hard carbon. However, once you use the bio-waste to produce the hard carbon, you need to use acid or basic treatment pre-pyrolysis or after pyrolysis in order to remove all the impurities of this waste, as well